As you know, the climate alarmism has a twin brother, doesn't it? It goes by the name of renewable energy zealotry. And there have been some new developments there, by the way. This report in the Daily Telegraph looks at business groups, especially those involved in the energy transition, calling for an even greater and faster shift to renewable energy. One of them says we've got to get beyond 70% renewables within 8 years, and still others are pushing for 100%. Now, there's one big problem for these evangelists and many of the rent seekers in this industry, and that is that it cannot be done. Only countries with massive hydro have any chance of being 100% renewable. The rest of the world just can't do it with existing technology. That's just the reality. It's what all the experts say. And no nation has done it. That's the proof. Storage, of course, as you know, is the biggest problem. But there are plenty of other hurdles, such as where to put the wind turbines, the solar farms, and the transmission lines. We've shown you the environmental concerns about wind farms being built in Queensland, with bushland being cleared and scarred. We've shown you the concerns of cray fishermen in South Australia and tourism operators in New South Wales about multi-billion dollar plans for offshore wind turbines. We've shown you how farmers in New South Wales and Victoria are arcing up about plans to push transmission lines through their properties to link renewables to the national grid. And now the Daily Telegraph has revealed how more than $300 million will need to be spent on a new railway underpass or town bypass to allow wind turbines to be transported from the port of Newcastle to new renewable energy zones. Just another case of the costs and impracticalities of renewable energy ruining the green dreams. Of course, these are usually wind turbines that are imported from China, where they're made from our ore, often with the help of our coal and gas, and without them having to worry about their massive and expanding greenhouse gas emissions. And as this goes on, we keep being told this.
We're not walking away from our commitment to get more renewables into the system. And yes, they are the cheapest form of energy available, the cheapest form of energy that's ever been available.
Yeah, if you believe that, you probably believe the government has cut your power bill by $275.